Windows 10 Sandbox is a great way to test potentially dangerous applications, like malware files. So in this video, you are going to find out how to use Windows 10 Sandbox to test potentially malicious files. So basically, we are going to put Sandbox to the test. Now to find out how to enable Sandbox on Windows 10, please check the link in the video description. I have a video specifically for that. We are going to test actual malware files, and then you are going to find out how to avoid certain big mistakes. So as you can see here, I have Windows Sandbox opened and I have Firefox installed on it. And I also have two links to dangerous virus files. So the moment I open those links, it's going to download a virus automatically. Alright, now I'm going to open the first virus file, and as you can see, it prompts me to download 11.exe. Clearly a very suspicious file. And let me download it right now. There you go, it's downloaded. Now look at this, when I download this file, Firefox warns me that this file contains malware. But that is the point of this tutorial. We are actually going to put this to the test, so we are going to run it. But before doing that, let us download the second file as well, because we are going to try to run both of them. And there you go, once again, Firefox is warning me to be careful because this file also contains malware. Alright, let's try this one. Let's see if it works. Go past through the warnings, okay. Alright, so far this one does not seem to work. Let's try the second one now, and let's see if it works. 11.exe, let's see if it works. And more warnings, and let's see. Let me click more info, let's run it anyway, and there you go. The virus is now running on my computer. But that's too bad for the virus, because it's not running on my actual computer. It's running on a virtual machine. It's running from Windows Sandbox. So in a way, this virtual machine is now officially infected. But as I just said, my actual machine is running just fine. For example, these files were downloaded in the downloads folder, right? Well, if I go to the downloads folder from the virtual machine from Windows Sandbox, I can see those two files. So let me go there right now, and let me go to downloads. So I'm going to open the file location, and there you go, it takes me to the downloads folder. And as you can see, here they are, the two malware files. And now I'm going to go to my actual computer, my real Windows 10 PC. Let me go there, let me click the start button, and then type downloads in the search field. And let me click on the download icon. There you go. It takes me to the downloads folder. And look, what don't you see? Clearly, you don't see those two files, those two malware files. So those files are in the virtual machine, but they're not on my actual computer. So when might you actually want to do this, to actually download viruses? Well, let's suppose someone suspicious sends you an email with an attachment, and you doubt, and you are reluctant to download it. And of course, rightfully so. Well, by using Windows Sandbox, you can download that attachment. And if it does behave strangely, then you know for a fact it was indeed a malicious file. And of course, the good news is that malicious file is trapped within Sandbox. It cannot infect your actual computer. Now, here are some situations where you really need to be careful. First of all, you cannot use Windows Sandbox to test fake or phishing websites. This includes, for example, a website that pretends to be your bank account, but in reality, it's a total fraud. If you enter your username and password, well, sadly, you will get hacked. And this is because you are simply accessing a website. You're not downloading anything. As such, Windows Sandbox will not make a difference. Another big mistake you need to avoid is forgetting when you're not using Windows Sandbox. Sadly, this can easily happen. You think you're using Windows Sandbox when in reality you are using your actual Windows PC. One thing you can do is change the background or wallpaper of your actual Windows 10 PC. So that way when you go into Sandbox, you see that the wallpaper is different. And so as a result, you know that you are in Sandbox. Something else you can do is to use Windows 10 Sandbox in full screen. Here's why. Well, when you use Windows Sandbox in full screen, you always see this connection bar on top. So as a result, you will always know that you are in Sandbox. But if you don't like it, you can also unpin it so that it disappears. However, it does make it easier for you to realize you are using Sandbox, not your actual Windows 10 PC, so that you don't use one for the other. So overall, as you can see, using Windows 10 Sandbox is very straightforward. And speaking of straightforward, for more easy, simple, straightforward tutorials like this, please subscribe and leave some comments below, and thanks for watching.